Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 7 of Minecraft Mod Sauce. Aw yeah. So, first of all, I changed away from my googly eyes to this little pool hat, because I think it looks a little bit nicer and not as trolly as it was before. But yeah, so as you can see, I did myself a lot of work between the episodes. First of all, I created this little machine room, and the second thing is I done goofed up because I didn't realize I already had a aloe smelter, but as I created an extra one last episode, derp. But that means that I only got one dedicated to processing and one for manual use, which I guess is pretty nice too. So yeah, it's pretty cool. I also moved all my power stuff over there, which is pretty cool. Just quickly show you guys, if I charge my stuff, you'll be able to see a burst of power coming from this thing. Just like that. Just all those things depleting their internal charge instantly to charge my stuff, which is pretty cool if you ask me. But yeah. So also between the episodes, I did myself a lot of crafting preparations. As you can see, I got all of these set up out here. So yeah, let's get started about showing you what I made. So first of all, I got myself 2 leadstone thrusters. Prepared the recipes for that. Because, like I said last episode, I wanted to try out a jetpack. A leadstone jetpack, to be precise. Awesome. Then the next thing that I crafted was some free runners for mechanism. These aren't too bad to make. I only needed to make some enriched alloys, which are made with the metallurgic infuser that I created during the episode. Really easy stuff to make. So yes, really proud of this. This thing, I believe, gives you a faster walk speed and step assist. So that's really awesome. Then right here, I got myself the Traveler's Goggles from Tinker's Construct, which allow me to zoom. And I got myself a knapsack. Did I create anything there? Oh, I did. And a Traveler's Belt. Awesome. So these 3 things are all from Tinker's Construct. And let's just show them. So first of all, let me quickly charge this stuff up. It shouldn't take too long because their internal buffers aren't too big. So let's see. I take these 2 off. Not this one. This and this. And there we go. This already looks awesome. So, let's see. Then what I need to do is put this in there. This in... Oh, I need to actually wear this on my head. Aw, I thought this was also would grant me... Wait, what? This thing has better protection than this one? Okay. And the belt goes there. Awesome. So, I do need to still find out how to activate the jetpack, but I will do that in a sec. So, first of all, I can very quickly switch out from a hotbar just by hitting B, which that's also, confusing with my other key. But as you can see now, let's see. Oh, no, it doesn't say anything. But every time I hit B, it will swap my inventory with an extra one. So, pretty much, I got 2 hotbars now. Awesome. Then I can press G to turn on night vision, it seems. Really? This thing grants night vision? Oh, wow, that's pretty overpowered. And Z for me to be able to zoom in. And I still need to change some of the key configs just because they mess with my minimap and such. But I will fix that in a minute. Then I got myself the knapsack, which is pretty much an extra inventory. Just an extra bag, which is pretty awesome. Then I got the free runners, and I'm not sure if I need to activate them. No, I do not. So pretty much, as you can see, they give me step assist. And the jetpack automatically works when I hit space. Unless I find out a way to activate the hover mode, which I cannot find yet. But this allows me to fly. Let's see, is there... Allows flight, must be one of the chests. How do I... Hover modes? Teleports. Let's quickly see if there's a key for that. Simple jetpacks, maybe movement, multiplayer, blah, 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 blah. Simple jetpacks. Switch mode, see, no. Let me quickly switch all my key binds up and I will be right back. Alright, there we go. So, like I said, I can zoom in. I can activate the hover mode, which pretty much will descend me very slowly. And I can now change my belt pretty easily. So I can have, like, this stuff on my belt, which I don't normally need all the time. And then I can just switch quickly between the two. And they won't take up any more inventory. So that's really awesome. Really, you know, quite impressed with that, actually. How that all works. But yeah, pretty cool. This looks so cool, actually, with the goggles and everything. So yes, today, what do I want to do? Well, like I said last episode, today I would like to work on more machines. There are so many more machines and stuff that I would like to create, and maybe even do some upgrades to stuff like this once I actually get the machines. So I think it will be pretty cool. So, for example, one of the set of machines that I would mind to make is from Thermal Expansion. Thermal Expansion adds a lot of different machines, each one of them having their own specific very awesome function, and I definitely want to try to mess with this stuff. For example, I don't need these three, but I do want a induction smelter, magma crucible, fluid transposer, maybe this one, I don't know yet. Igneous extruder, sure. Don't need that one, and don't need these two. But definitely those three are what I would like to get, at least to try out. So, let's quickly prepare those recipes for you guys, and I will be right back. Alright guys, so I got myself the induction smelter, the magma crucible, and the fluid transposer. Awesome. Now let's quickly get out some golden kinesis pipes. Switch my inventory around, because I got a wrench on this inventory, and I still absolutely love the way that works. Then I will quickly, let's see, I need three more places, so let me need to remember what key to switch. Also quite important, I guess, to set this all up properly. And why is this one being annoying? There we go. And I didn't even need to do that, because I forgot I got a jetpack now, which is still freakingly awesome. So let's see, induction smelter, magma crucible, fluid transposer. Let me also do this, so now I think of it. Let me put this machine right there. Put some torches down, because this area is not lit up very properly. And then, where is the... There we go, capacitor bank. Can go right there to charge my stuff. Awesome. So, just a quick guide for you guys. The induction smelter is used to combine two different materials. Let's quickly see if I can find some of those recipes. Just like right here, like silver and gold to create electrum, for example, and a lot more recipes. The magma crucible is used to smelt down specific items, like redstone, cryophium, enderpearls, whatever you want. And then we got the fluid transposer, which is used to put liquids into containers and other blocks that, you know, can do something with liquids, for example. Like, is there anything, a good example that I can quickly show you guys? I don't think so. No? Oh, yes. For example, you can insert resonant ender into obsidian, and you get yourself ender-infused obsidian. That's one of the cool things you can do with this. So, now what I want to make is possibly upgrade my leadstone jetpack. Let's quickly find out what that was. Jetpack. Into a reinforced jetpack, which requires... a hardened jetpack, which requires some invar, which is doable. And then maybe also upgrade it to a reinforced jetpack. This thing stores already a lot more than the other one, and I am assuming this one allows you to fly a lot faster too. So I think this will be pretty cool. So I'm not sure how much work this will be, so I will definitely think about quickly doing this, and then I will see you guys in a sec. Alright guys, so first of all I got the hardened flux capacitor. Then I got myself two hardened thrusters, and these were more expensive to make than I expected them to be. And then all I need to do is, I believe, put this together, and I got myself a hardened jetpack. Woohoo! Let's see how much power this takes to charge. It takes a little bit longer, and as you can see, it will probably drain a lot of power. Or, well, yeah, it really is draining a lot of power from my capacitor bank. But this should be recharging itself quite soon. And then, wow, this thing is already has a higher capacity than this capacitor bank on its own. Oh wow, didn't think of that. Let's see how much of an improvement this thing is. So let's quickly turn night vision on. And it does allow me to fly a little bit faster too, I think. But the main cool thing that I like about this, and why does it, yeah. The main cool thing is that this thing has a lot bigger of a inventory, energy buffer. So this will allow me to just be, you know, allow me to not be scared when I'm out of the field that I will be running out of power, because this thing has a massive buffer of power, which is awesome. And I think I even got fall protection from either this one or this one. But yeah, that's really awesome. So for the next upgrade, the reinforced one, I need Electrum. And this requires Magmatic, which requires more Invar and Signalium. And Signalium is made with... Yeah, that's... okay, this one will have to wait for now. But I will definitely try to get into some of that stuff later on. But for now, I think we're pretty set already. So, what I want to do next? That's the good question. Because there is so much stuff that I want or could make, potentially. And, oh wow, what's all of this stuff? Flight control units, what? Dark Solarium jet plate. Oh wow, I don't even know what half the stuff is, but it looks cool. And expensive. But really cool. So yes, let me quickly think about what I want to make, and I will be right back. Okay, so the next thing that I want to make is probably a couple of these upgrades. For example, the double layer and the octetic upgrade, which require the alloy smelter, which I am glad that I made now. So first of all, I will need to get myself some energetic alloy. Let's just make 16 of that stuff. Like that. Pretty cool. So pretty much this thing allows me to not only be used in recipes, like the normal capacitor bank, which is something I do want to make soon, more improved thrusters, energetic jetpack. Oh wait, this is also a tier 1 jetpack. Energetic one, which is made with energetic alloy, double layer capacitors, enhanced conduits. Guys, maybe this is a good second tier option. Possibly. It's maybe a different step, but I think it will be cool to actually make this once I actually get a lot more energetic alloy. Yep, something I will definitely think about. So let me quickly wait for this all to process, and I'll be right back. Okay, guys. So I got myself some pulverized coal. I quickly made myself a SAG mill, because apparently you need to have a SAG mill to pulverize coal and not just a normal pulverizer from thermal expansion, sadly. So I had to do pretty much a bit of extra work for that. But now I should be able to create some double layer capacitors. Let's quickly add this recipe. And then what do I need to put in the middle? The coal. There we go. Double layer capacitors. So pretty much what this should be able to do is, let's see, what one should I put this in or use this with? I don't know yet. Maybe you can I upgrade it to the octetic one already? That will require me to only have one though, which is not really what I want. Nope, let's just put this in here for now. So as you can see, this doubles the amount of power in this thing and the amount of speed. So currently its maximum is 20 RF per tick. Now it's up to 60. So does that also triple the speed, or just triple the energy and double the speed? I'm not sure. But anyway, this works awesomely, because now this thing will be a lot faster. As you can see already, working very smoothly. Woohoo! Awesome stuff. So today, for the rest of the episode, what I probably want to do is do a little bit of work outside, just pretty much checking out what's up with the environment and such. Because there's so much stuff to do, and I want to think about what I actually want to do later on. Because, like I said, I really would like to get more into farming in this world. But to be able to do that, I will probably need to discover what's around there. And see what I can find. Maybe make a nice place, not just right here, that I can dedicate myself to farming without having to terraform too much. I mean, in theory, I could take this entire area down, but why would I do that if I can find another nice place to actually build the farm? And yep, as you can see, I'm really in love with my jetpack. Love this stuff. Like, I really, really do. Just zoom. Woo! Hey, look out. There, that's my turtle. Not moving because this thing already finished mining, but still. Woohoo! Cool stuff. Yeah, so much fun. So, yeah, let me just quickly just look around a bit, see if I can find anything interesting for you guys to see, and I will be right back. Okay, so after a little bit of flying around, I found out about Shadowstar's base. His base is around 200, 300 blocks, that direction, pretty cool. But pretty much what I found out is that he has a portal to the mining dimension. And I thought, why don't I have one yet? So that's, I think, a good idea to build today. So I still got quite some time, I think. So let's see. First of all, I will probably need to make the mining multi-tool, which is a stone pickaxe, a piece of flint, stone bricks, chiseled bricks, and that thing. That's for some reason a really strange recipe, if you ask me. But okay, I guess. So I still need the flint and steel, and most of the other stuff I already have in my inventory, it seems. More stone, actually. There we go. So, flint, steel, universal recipes, yay. Stone pickaxe. I'm not quite sure how this completely works, but I'll have to see about that. Then I need another stick, got that, and two normal bricks, and of course shift clicking won't work. Annoying little thing. One mining multi-tool. I'm not sure how I completely use this. But I'll, you know, look up, see about that. Maybe make a book. Let's see. Do I got the materials to make a book? I got some. Wait, I even have some books, I believe. Really? No way? I really have no books. Huh, okay. I guess I. Huh, I really thought I had some books. So, let's see, make really get some of this stuff, some more of this, get a book, combine these two, I think, and you get yourself a guide. Fair enough. So I need to get myself some of these bricks. Not too bad, I think. So I guess I need 14, the same amount you need in a normal portal. And stop glitching in my doorway. Maybe I should put it just opposite of this. So two blocks, and then I can mine this out. There we go. And how do I light it? Like, maybe doing with this thing too? Hey! To go through the portal, you have to sneak in. So let's quickly eat, and then we'll head into the mining dimension. Which is the place where I'll be putting my... Oh, wow. Woohoo! Yay for a mining world. This is going to be a lot better to put my turtle, because now I won't be have any issues with... Yeah, just world holes in the overworld. Pretty cool. So, I guess this would be a good wrapping up point for now, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed. Probably what I will do between the episode or next episode is start thinking of a better method for mining. So think about auto-sorting, sending stuff over to the overworld, possibly. And I think that will be all nice and cool. So, thanks for watching, guys. Please leave a rating. And I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care.